this bitch had the nerve to tattletale on me on the VIP line. I could have met Taylor Momsen. This bitch. I'm still not over it. The story behind the VIP tickets. I'm so glad I do not talk to these people ever again. But she promised me, this girl. Oh, this is the girl Karen. So, flashback to Karen. She's like some psycho chick that I befriended, but all's well and ends well. I don't talk to her anymore, so I'm all good from here. But here's a story from how she promised me a VIP ticket that was supposed to be for her boyfriend that ended up breaking up with her a week before the concert. She promised me the ticket, I can have his ticket like a month or so in advance, just in case. And I was like, yes, I get to meet the bands, get them signed, get them whatever. Okay. Ends up giving her ticket to the ex-boyfriend. So I was like, the ex-boyfriend that was my ex-boyfriend that you practically, you know, pushed together and sabotaged, not once, but twice. That sounds fair. And her mother was like, I'm afraid Bryn was going to abuse the drinking thing with the drink, because there was like a drinking free pass with the VIP passes. I'm like, honey, I don't drink for one, and two, I'm underage. So why would they even bother trying to give me a ticket for that if I'm, one, 19, and two, I would never touch a drink a day in my life. Or drink just because if I can, you know what I mean? I don't really care for that scene. I don't do that crap. So I was really offended by how her mom just assumed I was gonna abuse the drinking pass. And so she ended up giving the ticket to the ex-boyfriend who she's dating now for like the seventh time, but whatever. But like at the concert for the Pretty Reckless, they don't even know who the freaking band is. They don't even know who they are. I showed them maybe five songs and that was it. They don't know who they are as people. They don't even know their music and type and what they stand for. They just know those five songs if they even bothered looking up any other ones. And I tried sneaking into the VIP line just so I can be like, you've saved my best friend's life, thank you for that, I am appreciative of you and your music, you're super talented, I love you, blah blah blah, okay? I was all for that, and then this bitch, legitimately pushed me out of the line and was like, you don't have a VIP pass, and then the security guard heard that and was like, ma'am? So I heard a tap on my shoulder 2 seconds later, and the guy was like, ma'am, do you have a VIP pass with this line? I'm like, yes. They're like, let me see your wrist. No, get out of the line. You don't belong in this line. I'm like, are you fucking serious? This bitch doesn't even know who they are. I know every single album. I know every single video. I even know a lot of their interviews to know who they are as people. They don't know shit about them, and I know who they, and I know what they did in my life to protect my best friend and to protect me, because if she was out of here, I would never survive this fucking life. So really, I'm staying in this fucking VIP line in this bitch. This bitch was like, she tried to sneak into the line, sir. I ended up having to wait after the fact that my friend was out of the line. I was like, okay, fine. Can you at least get me an autograph from Taylor, please? And this bitch had the nerve. She's like, I tried, but they wouldn't sign anything past like three things or past like three signatures, so I couldn't get anything once I got Papa Roaches and all that. I'm like, that's bullshit. That's a bull fucking shit lie. You know better than that, than to lie to me. And I even brought it up to my best friend. I was like, hey, by any chance, do they have some kind of limited signature thing going on? And she's like, fuck no, I got them to sign practically everything I had in my hands. I was like, huh. I knew that was a bullshit lie. Anyway, so like, I ended up not getting a signature from any of them. I didn't even get the chance to say hi or meet them, but I will... Actually, you can check out my best friend's YouTube channel, and she actually has a video of her meeting them. And then I have the video of them performing. So you can check those videos out if you want. That was my story time of the time that I went to a lunatic luau and practically snuck into a VIP line. So yeah. So thank you for listening. I ended up seeing Hailstorm a second time up close, almost a year later. in the same place I actually visited, but that's a whole different story of me visiting Virginia from a different state for like a week. So I hope you like this video. Give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Update on life. Actually, remember how my previous video I said I had a boyfriend? Less than 12 hours later, all hell broke loose. So this is gonna be the last time I speak of him or even show him. This is gonna be the last time I do anything involving him. I've been through enough bullshit excuses in my life. I thought he was someone different. I thought he was the one. I guess you never know until it's too late. So I shall be fine. He obviously didn't shatter me too well. He just bruised me. So it's okay. I'm fine. Not that anyone probably would care, because no one really follows me on YouTube, but I'm fine. And, well, I deserve better than what I've allowed myself to be put through for the last 6 months. So it's amazing how much time can change a person, how much things can change within a short period of time. So a lot has happened. I wish him the best. Me being nice, I wish him the best, but I don't want to contact him. I don't want him contacting me. It's fine. But yeah, I'm single and not ready to mingle, but one day I probably will be and I will be fine.